Freddy. Look, what's all that red stuff on their fur?
Just like McCarthy's cheek.
I never saw anything like this before.
Even the bears look scared.
Of what, man? And where are they all going?
It's not where they're going that worries me. It's what are they running away from?
Hey everybody, I'm Tatsudoshi.
Corn and bourbon.
And this time we'll be reviewing a movie that I'm particularly fond of, and I liked a long time ago, and we're revisiting it. It's called Dreamcatcher!
Dreamcatcher, oh
hey! It's based on a Stephen King book!
Ooh, that guy makes a lot of books.
Okay, so let me give you a little history about Stephen King and me. I don't like Stephen King very much. I just don't.
I hear some booze.
Shut up, okay? Fuck the booze. Most of his books are fairly lazy, and most of his creature things that he does are, oh, it's an evil car, oh, it's a dog,
tomato,
oh, no, but, so, it really is hard for me to like things like Cujo and you know, all those things like that, but Dreamcatcher, actually, I thoroughly enjoyed it a long time ago. By chance, I rented the DVD and as a movie night with me and my dad, and we sat down and we watched it. I was like, damn, that was pretty good. I didn't expect it to be that good. I just grabbed it on a whim because it looked neat. The box art looked neat. So, yes, it is based on a book because it's Stephen King, but I liked it back then, and you said you saw it a long time ago, too. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. What was your history with Dreamcatcher?
I think I liked it as a kid as well, or when I was younger and stuff, because it was an interesting story and how they told it. And
did you like see it in theaters, or did you see this DVD or
VHS?
HBO.
Oh, HBO.
Yeah.
HBO. So you didn't even go out of your way to see. You just like, oh, this is on.
Yeah. We had.
We had the hubbo. You had the hubbo.
I think we had HBO. We had all the channels at one time.
Back in the good old days. I never had those channels. All
right.
But, so, when we saw it on the Netflix-o, we were like, huh, we should watch that again. So we sat down and watched it again. And, damn, it's still pretty freaking good. Again, it's Stephen King, so expect creatures, monsters, killing, death, scary stuff, pseudo-scary stuff, not very scary stuff, and plot twists that don't particularly make any sense, but they're plot twists anyway.
Right.
But as far as the whole, you know, plot line doesn't really make sense, but, you know, it's fun anyway. So it's one of those things that you kind of have that suspension of disbelief thing that everybody seems to be all and on about all the time. But I do like the powers that these guys have. They're not like super over mega right. powered.
It basically starts out with like four guys, and
four guys rescue a retarded kid, and they're like, well, they were off to see some prom queen's vagina that was pasted. I really wish I wasn't kidding.
Right.
I wish I wasn't kidding. For a little before, like they were what, like junior high kids. At the time, they're like, yeah, we're junior high. Let's go see a vagina that's in a wall in this old factory.
Yeah!
In the old days. So they go over there and they see a bunch of, like, looks like high schoolers or at least older kids than them. Beating up on a retarded kid and trying to make him eat a dog turd.
Yep.
And they're like, hey, fuck you, stop it. And they get into a verbal fight and they're like, well, you know, if you don't stop it, Speedy Gonzales over here with the glass is going to run like a motherfucker over there and get that. And you go get his parents and the police, and they're going to kick your ass.
Yeah, well, so, I'm going to tell you guys, no, you're not. We'll beat the shit out of you. This guy's the fastest cat alive. You can't touch him.
He's the fastest cat alive.
Well, okay, well, and the other guy was just like, come on, let's beat him. He just grabs two rocks. He's like, come on, I'll take you, pussies.
So,
and he's just like, these guys are retarded, so they just...
So they just, the older kids just left. It was like, you'll regret this. And like,
we'll get you! We'll get you! And they're like, no, are you alright? You retired?
And so, your pants. So basically, they find this kid and he's like, they ask him, are you Douglas? And he goes, yeah, I'm Duddits. It's like, Duddits? Dunnett! I'm Dunnett!
Alright, that sounds cool. We're gonna check out this vagina
now. We're gonna call you Dunnett, and let's go look at this vagina, Dunnett. So they go
and that's not a vagina, damn.
No, they look at the picture, and it's like, that's not the prom queen, that's like her grandma.
That's an old
picture.
So we came for him. They felt like they were connected to this kid, so they became friends with him.
They became friends, and they quickly found out about that he had some sort of connection. And they were all, like, connected in some weird way through this kid, Douglas / Dunnett. And they found out that when they tried to do this one, like, adventure, they were trying to find this missing girl, that he gave them powers. Right. Each of them had their own little powers, like telepathy and the ability to find things and so on and so forth. And, like, the cool twirly fingers, space-time rift, I'm gonna go this way kind of stuff. And it's like, this kid's really special, and it's like, you know, he's like the culmination of all this cool stuff. It's like, all the stuff that we dreamed about, and they called this kid their dream catcher. And they had this cool little, you know, meshed dream catcher together that they made to symbolize their friendship and so on and so forth. And, you know, time goes by, they become adults, and they don't get to hang out as much anymore, but they take their yearly trip to this place in the mountains to hang out and be friends with each other and, you know, reminisce about the old days, talk about their adventures, fuck around, hunt some deer, shit like that. And then all of a sudden, aliens! Giant aliens come down and an alien spaceship crash lands, but they don't know that. And then, like, some people get infected and they help these people. They're like, oh, they're sick and stuff like that. But it turns out that there's fucking aliens inside them and they spew out and it's really gross and shit.
Right.
And just lots of gross shit happens in this movie, but it's not particularly, like, vomit worthy. It's just like, right. Ew.
It's just like, ugh, nasty. Like, don't want to touch it. But, by the way, Morgan Freeman. In this, in case you guys
Reason to watch this, Morgan Freeman's go bananas.
Man, Morgan Freeman's like he's playing
insane
general and stuff. He's just like, I told you once, boy, don't lie to me because I pulled a cap in your
Scouts honor, all you need to do is raise those two fingers and say, Scouts honor, Scouts honor,
motherfucker. So he's in there, he's just playing the badass, and of course, he's good in every freaking role because he's damn Morgan Freeman. So you just don't mess with him. You throw in the movie, he's going to do good at it there.
Because he's Morgan Freeman. Because he's
Morgan Freeman. So anyway, along with this Morgan Freeman being in the movie.
Morgan Freeman's a little salt and pepper.
There's also a couple other actors that are pretty good that weren't really known before they did his movie.
That guy from My Name is Earl?
Yeah, that guy from My Name is Earl does, he did a couple of voices that you know and characters.
Two faces in this movie.
Two faces? Tommy Lee Jones.
Definitely not Tommy Lee Jones.
Not
that Two-Face, and not Black Two-Face either. What Black Two-Face? Harvey Dent in the Batman, never mind, okay. But Two-Face from The Dark Knight, he's in this, and they both do a really good job. In fact, all the acting in this is really well done. And, you know, you really do have to have that suspension of disbelief, especially because it's Stephen King. Mm-hmm. But it's really, it's a fun movie. There's nothing really super amazing about it, but it's just one of Stephen King's better movies. And I have never read the book, and I wonder if the book's better, but I dare not read a Stephen King novel because I haven't liked one yet. Mm. I've liked some of the Stephen King movies, but I haven't liked his books so much. But I think what I like about this movie most is the alien design. They're like giant dong velociraptors.
It's cool because the alien design, when you actually see the alien design and stuff, it's basically a big giant the standard, you know, big giant headed, black eye, grayish.
Gray alien kind of thing. Typical, big ass.
Right, but he has a second form that he transforms. He shows you his back, and then he's like on all fours, and he has like a big giant mouth vagina that has a lot of teeth.
And he eats you with his mouth vagina.
And he eats you with his mouth vagina.
And that's his real form. They have the ability to like project what you want to see.
Right.
So they, if you expect to see an alien that's like, you know, big head, gray, all soft,
right.
It's like, oh, I want to touch you, we're friends, and stuff like that. Yeah, well, this is a giant dong velociraptor. It doesn't have arms. It's got big, meaty velociraptor legs.
Right.
And it's a big dong.
And it's got like a freaking like 4-foot mouth or something like that. So it just goes chomp right on you.
And when you first see it, it's just a slug. Probably about yay big.
Right.
With the like vagina mouth.
Kind of like a foot long.
Yeah, kind of like a foot long. And you get to see its earlier form too, which is a much smaller, about this big little
tiny little dong.
But once it gets to its big form, it's got the big fucking meat velociraptor legs, big 4-foot vagina mouth with teeth.
And it's really terrifying.
It really is scary looking. But then you think about it, it's like, ha, dong alien.
Right.
But at least it's all scary.
Right, but then he's basically just like attacking these guys, but these guys are they're the special squad. So
you basically have three things going on. Alien wants to destroy the world. Government wants to destroy the aliens, and these guys caught in the middle.
Right.
And so you have all these things going on at the same time. Lots of little plot twists here and there, but it really is a fun movie, and I really don't want to spoil the stereotypical Stephen King twist ending, but it really is fun, and it's not that long. It's worth watching. It's streaming on Netflix, so if you have Netflix already, then you can just beep on your 360, your Wii, or your PS3, or your Netflix dongle, or your live streaming on your computer, and watch it. It's a fun movie. It's definitely one of those movie night movies, in my opinion, where, you know, it's like, most people haven't seen Dreamcatcher, and it's a good excuse to say, hey, you know, everybody come over, we'll have a pizza night and watch a movie. And this is definitely one of those movies to watch with a bunch of friends, especially if they haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, so it's interesting. So grab that popcorn and go on.
Grab that popcorn, grab that pizza, grab a beer, grab your friends,
and watch your ass, because here it comes.
Oh yeah, by the way, they come and they go into your mouth, the spores come into your mouth, and the alien slug comes out your ass.
Bloody.
Bloody. Gross. They eat your ass out.
Enjoy.
Gross.